Well, if you keep up on the latest technology, you've probably heard of 3D printing. The innovative manufacturing technology can be used to make everything from medical tools to airline parts. And as Sarah Fenton reports, some Indiana schools are beginning to use it to introduce students to the science, technology, engineering, and math, or STEM fields.
Here's how a 3D printer works. It starts with a computer design that acts as a kind of blueprint.
And we basically take a 3D model, and we slice it up into multiple layers, and then we deposit the melted, extruded plastic. In this case, we're using ABS, same material that they use to make Legos.
In just a few hours, the molten material is printed into a usable product. In this case, a set of working gears. Kim Brand calls it a fascinating process to watch, and he hopes it catches the attention of high school students.
The key is not the printer. The printer is just a trick to get kids interested in engineering.
Brand recently started a pilot program through his Indianapolis-based company, 3D Parts Manufacturing. With a grant from the Tech Point Foundation for Youth, 3D Parts Manufacturing is putting small 3D printers in 10 schools across the state as part of a project they're calling Masters of the Universe.
It's going to rotate very fast compared to the other one.
John Davis teaches tech ed at Crepkside Middle School in Carmel. He's one of the first teachers to get a printer and says his students pounced on it as soon as it was delivered earlier this year.
The questions just kept coming and coming and coming. It was like opening a box and there's a glow inside, and all of a sudden everybody wanted to peek in.
Davis's goal, and the goal of the Masters of the Universe initiative, is to use 3D printing to interest students in technology fields as part of a nationwide effort to align career paths to the economy's demands. And it's working.
We see applications for connections to so much of the learning that they're doing, not just here elsewhere in tech ed, but elsewhere in the building. The students were fascinated by the fact that it operates on the same X, Y, and Z coordinates that they use in math class. Then someone else said, does it use the same G codes that we use in CNC machining? Yes, it does.
Only a handful of teachers have gotten to use their printers. Many more plan on getting projects off the ground once the new school year starts. 3D Parts Manufacturing has supplied teachers with a book of lesson plans they can use alongside their existing curriculum. But first, teachers have to learn how to use the new devices.
Do your distance, size of your duct.
Today at IUPUI in Indianapolis, the teachers have become the students. This is one of several workshops being held this summer that shows teachers how to use 3D printers. In these sample projects, students use concepts culled from geometry and computer science to create a computer model that's then fed into the printer. Designs include toys, gears, and small toy animals. While all the teachers here are learning the same thing, when they go back to their schools, they'll come up with ways to make the printers and the projects they're used for their own. At North Davies Community Schools in Elnora, teachers plan on incorporating the printers into their science and math curriculum. Technology coordinator Todd Whitlock hopes the printers will provide some engineering know-how that could lead to lifelong careers for his students.
We all want the same thing for kids, and that's to expose them to new opportunities, and this is a perfect example that lets us do that.
As we mentioned, the program is really just starting to get off the ground, but officials from the company supplying the printers say they're getting so much positive feedback, they're already considering expanding it.